Hey, Big Mike here. Found a 53success.com. Hey, listen, if you need clients and cash flow, go to 53success.com and book in a free strategy session today. How's everyone doing? Let's get into it. Okay, this is about how to calculate your total revenue, total cost, and profit, which are non-emergency medical transportation business. If you have a fleet of vehicles for your non-emergency medical transportation business, your cost and revenue calculations will be a bit more complex. Here are some additional factors to consider. Vehicle cost. You'll need to calculate the cost of purchasing or leasing your vehicles, as well as any maintenance, repairs or upgrades required to keep them in good condition. Drivers, you'll need to factor in the cost of hiring and training drivers, as well as any benefits or insurance coverage you provide. Fuel costs, you'll need to estimate the cost of fuel for each vehicle based on the number of trips you make and the distance you travel. Revenue per vehicle. You need to calculate the revenue you generate from each vehicle by multiplying the number of trips it makes by the rate you charge for each trip. Overall revenue. You need to add up the revenue generated by all of your vehicles to determine your total revenue. To calculate profit, you can use the same formula that I use. And that's the total revenue cost equals profit. By analyzing your cost and revenue for each vehicle, you can identify which vehicles are most profitable and where you might need to make adjustments to improve your overall profitability. This can also help you make decisions about whether to add or retire vehicles from your fleet. And the formula is revenue minus cost equals profit. There are several key factors to consider when running a non-emergency medical transportation business, including costs. You'll need to calculate the cost of operating your business, including the cost of vehicles, insurance, fuel, maintenance, and any necessary licenses and permits. Revenue. You'll need to determine how much revenue you can generate by charging for transportation services. This will depend on factors such as the number of clients you have, the distance you travel, and the rates you charge. Profit margin. You'll need to calculate your profit margin by subtracting your cost from your revenue. This will help you determine whether your business is profitable and whether you need to make any adjustments to your rates or expenses. To calculate these factors, you can use a simple formula. Revenue minus cost equals profit. For example, if your revenue for a month is $10,000 and your costs are $8,000, your profit will be $2,000. It is important to regularly monitor and analyze your financial data to ensure that your business is profitable and sustainable over the long term. You may also want to consider hiring an accountant or financial advisor to help you with this process. Or just get in touch with me at 53success.com and book in your free strategy session today. Okay, and what can I write off on non-emergency medical transportation? Okay, you can write off, as with any business, there are certain examples that you can write off as deductions on your non-emergency medical transportation, the business tax returns. Here are some of the common expenses that typically deductible for non-emergency business, non-emergency medical transportation businesses. Vehicle expense. This includes the cost of purchasing or leasing your vehicle, the fuel costs, repairs and maintenance, insurance and registration fees. Driver's expenses. This includes wages or salaries, benefits, payroll, taxes, training expenses. Office expenses. This includes the cost of rent, utilities, supplies and equipment, marketing and advertising expenses. This includes the cost of advertising, promotions, and other marketing material. Insurance expenses. This includes liability insurance, property insurance, and workers' compensation insurance. Professional fees. This includes the cost of hiring accountants, lawyers, and other professionals for tax preparation, legal advice, and other services. Depreciation. This includes the cost of hiring. This includes the loss of value of any asset over time, and is typically deducted over several years. It is important to keep accurate records of all your business expenses so that you can properly claim deductions on your tax returns. It's also a good idea to consult with a tax professional to ensure that you are taking advantage of all the available deductions and credits for your non-emergency medical transportation benefits. Okay. If you need more information, go to 53success.com and book in a free strategy session today. Bye for now.